Whew. Good morning. Welcome back to another day of Revival from the Bible. Just finishing up a morning run and thinking about our Bible reading today from Romans chapter 15, because there's a couple words that are used in there that come up maybe if you're exercising or you're running, and that is encouragement and endurance. Those both come up twice there in those opening verses of Romans chapter 15. And I think they're words that are good for us today, right? We know that the Christian life is not easy. The Bible says that over and over again, right? I mean, first of all, life isn't easy because we're living in a post-Genesis 3 world. Second of all, it says the Christian life, that's not going to be easy, because it says, hey, all who desire to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. Through many tribulations, you must enter the kingdom of heaven. And then right now, you know, we're in a situation that, our lives have been disruptive. And in all of those things, I mean, we could use some encouragement and some endurance, right? And so there's a couple things that I want you to notice. Look at verse 4. It says, "For whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that through endurance and through the encouragement of the scriptures, we might have hope." And then that leads to the prayer in verse 5, "May the God of endurance and encouragement grant you to live in such harmony with one another in accord with Christ Jesus." And it's interesting, this endurance and encouragement even comes in the context of what we've been really talking about from Romans 14, of building up the body of Christ, even when there's disagreements about, you know, secondary things that the Bible does not speak clearly to. I mean, that's what it gets to in verse 2. It says, "Let each of us please his neighbor for his good, to build him up." Now, the focus shouldn't be on ourselves, it should be on others. "For Christ did not please himself, but as it is written, the reproaches of those who reproached you fell on me." Right? So I want to give you again maybe some specific challenges to apply this today, that I want you to dig into the scriptures, because it says, hey, what was written, and even that's talking about the Old Testament, but for us, you know, the former days really includes the whole Bible. It was written so that you could have endurance, so that you could have encouragement. Are you getting endurance and encouragement out of the scriptures? So one challenge is that quote there in verse 3, "The reproaches of those who approached you fell on me." Do you know where that comes from? There's a homework assignment today. Go find out where that quote comes from and read the context and see what else you can learn from there. And then we see this idea of whatever was written, it was for us. So the other thing I want to encourage you to do today is to lean into the examples of Scripture. Lean into the examples of Scripture. And I want you to go find at least, you know, two examples maybe of characters in the Bible or situations in the Bible that will give you encouragement and endurance today. You are not the first person in the history of the people of God to experience difficulty in life. What are some examples that you can lean on today and find that encouragement and endurance? So find out where that quote comes from, and then I want you to just pray and think of a few examples from Scripture that'll inspire you and give you that encouragement and that endurance. And before we wrap up, I want to just give us a little warning, right? Because we're also reading the book of Judges. The book of Judges is a tricky book to go to find examples, right? Today we started reading the story of Samson. And as much as I might want to say, man, Samson, look at that man of strength, right? He was also a man of weakness, right? He had a weakness for women, clearly, that we're already seeing today. He didn't follow all the rules that God set for him, right? There's a lot of troubling things about Samson. But maybe the encouragement we can take from that, which, let's be clear, we should never ever use this as an excuse, but we see an encouragement that God uses even imperfect people and even the sin of people to accomplish his good in the world, right? I mean, we see from Samson, I mean, he runs after this Philistine woman. And that's not something a person from Israel should have done. But it even says God was doing this so that he could, eventually fight against the Philistines. And that was a purpose that God wanted to accomplish. So that's probably not so much an example for you to follow, but maybe that's an encouragement for you that even when other people sin, when other people do something that they're not supposed to do, like we see Samson doing in some of these things, God can still use that to accomplish his big picture purposes. So even right now, maybe you look at the actions of others and you're like, man, I don't know. Why are they doing this? Why are they doing that? Right? You can say, hey, that doesn't really matter because God's still on the throne and he can work everything for good. And maybe that's something that can encourage you today. So where does that quote come from? In verse 3 in Romans 15. Find that out. Read the context. Get encouragement from that. And then what are some other biblical examples that you're going to lean into that are going to help you be encouraged in your heart and help you endure in this season of life for you? So those are the things that I want you to focus on today. Let's pray real quick. God, we thank you for your scriptures. I even just thank you personally, God, how you revived my heart and encouraged me with these verses today. And I pray that they would encourage others. Lord, may we have encouragement and endurance through your word, God. And so I pray that people would go and do this and dig into your word and mine all the riches that are there, Lord, so that we can follow you with joy and with patience, no matter what season of life that we are in. And we pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, have a great day. I hope you've been revived from the Bible, and we will see you again, Lord willing, tomorrow.